Hello, creative people, and welcome to the final week of Inktober. This was very fun, but at the same time, this year I'm kind of glad that it's over. I think that's just because it was extremely hard to juggle everything in my normal day-to-day life with Inktober along with it. But I enjoyed Inktober nonetheless. I had a blast doing it. I have found new techniques that I really, really like. Like I said, I'm using multiple prompts this year, and I just kind of, like I said, I kind of picked and choose what I really liked and what really inspired me at that point. So yeah, I enjoyed it. Each prompt, like some of them are like, oh yeah, this is randomly in there, and then it's like the rest of them are, you know, the original Inktober prompt. I don't know why, but like the last like week was easier for me to do with the original prompt than the first, you know, 3 weeks. Don't really know why, I just had more inspiration for it. There was only like two, I think, out of this that was not part of the original Inktober. The first one that I did was Midnight. That was for the Nature Girl prompt, and I decided to go with Cinderella because she's my favorite, you know, Disney princess. And I just thought it would be really, really cute to add a little more, you know, Disney flair into Inktober, because why not? And then I have Dizzy, which I used as the Alice in Wonderland teacup ride because I always thought it was a fun ride. And I thought it'd be really cute to do. And I saw a Funko Pop of Alice actually riding the little teacup, and I don't know where on earth it is, but it's the most adorable thing ever, and I kind of want it. And then the next prompt was Tasty, and this one I had sketched out beforehand, and I started working on, what was that, day two, so that was Mindless, and I was plopping a whole bunch of ink onto a page, and I didn't realize that I had sketched a whole bunch of stuff on the page underneath. I didn't realize there was a page underneath, and there was a lot of pink splats that had seeped through the page and onto the sketch. So I had to kind of rework my initial color scheme for it. But I really enjoyed it though. Dark, these are the ones where I kind of like, I worked on the background first, then implemented all of the line work and the color. And this one I really, really like. I had fun working on the hair. I don't know what it is. Hair has become a thing that I was just like, oh, let me go ahead and do hair and make it really wavy and long and add a whole bunch of lines into it. Don't really know why, but I mean, it's fun. I don't know why. It's just fun to me. It adds like extra depth in my opinion. And then sometimes I do it and sometimes I don't. So I don't know if that's just like, I do the intricate lines on something I find more intriguing or not. I don't really know. But I had fun doing this, and I love how the red kind of just like added that extra like deep depth into it along with that purple. Now, this one was Coat, and I really like how this one turned out because I think this is the best version of each of my characters. So I mean, I have a lot of characters. If you haven't been here for a while, I have my own characters. I write books and stories, and a lot of the characters that you see are characters that I have already implemented into stories. So these are some of my main characters or side characters, and I just kind of want to, I don't know, kind of add them into it. And I mentioned this a little bit last week, but or a couple days ago, I should say. But I like implementing them into things in a, I don't know, like if someone just saw it, they would get the idea. But if they knew the characters, they would get more of the idea. So I kind of want it to be, you know, friendly to everyone who sees it. So it's like, oh yeah, they get it either way. But I have two of my main characters on the left and the center, and then you have the poor little guy on the very end freezing to death because he's not used to cold weather. But I think this is the best, one of my favorite sketches and drawings of them, because especially with the guys, I have a hard time sketching them because I have a hard time visualizing them. So this was a good challenge for me personally. And it was just really fun to work on kind of like slight expressions and then, you know, this one, you know, slightly extreme expression. I feel like I could have done a little more on that aspect, but I still really like this one. It's one of my favorites, which, oh my goodness, it just occurred to me that next month starts National Writing Month. I know I've said this before, but it's just really hitting me now. Like, oh boy, am I prepared for this? Nope. This is another prompt that I switched out for the Spooktober prompt. And instead of Jake Parker's prompt, which was ride, I turned it into monster. And I actually really like this one. At first I was thinking something like, I don't know, Sylvia from Monsters, Inc. And then I thought, I don't know, I kept thinking like Monsters, Inc., but I also wanted to be like slightly weird. And I don't know why, it's just something about it. When I think of monsters, I just, my initial go-to is like, ooh, draw a character or a monster that only has one eye. I don't know, there's something about it, just like the one big eye thing. And I made her kind of sassy, and instead of having like, you know, like Sylvia hair where it's snakes, I gave her eyeball hair. So she has a whole bunch of little eyeballs, you know, giving her looks and acting all shifty towards other people. So if she can't have an expression, then all of her hair can. But I feel like I could have done a little better with the detail of the hair. Maybe it's not as noticeable. It's kind of dark in my opinion, like the hair wise. I feel like I could have done a little, I don't know, something a little different. And then the other one was injured. I kind of implemented the characters again, kind of more of like an actual interaction, see if what I could do with that. And I found a technique that who was it? Casey Golden did it, and it looked really cool. So I was like, I'll try my hand at it. And I've tried it before a little bit, but this was like patience. And I think at the end, I was starting to lose a little bit of that patience, unfortunately. That plus I could not tell from where I was on the table because I was trying to record and make sure all these lines were straight at the exact same time. So it was a little something different. And then day 30 was catch, and I don't know, like, I think it's really cute. For some reason, all I kept thinking was, like, fish catching, which also reminded me of, Animal Crossing. I'm actually really excited for the new Animal Crossing. I never really played it until, probably about a year ago when Pocket Camp came out. I'm just gonna be honest here. I had no idea what Animal Crossing really was until Doodle Date mentioned it on their channel. And I was like, well, let me see what this is all about. And I don't know, it's like a really soothing game. So now I kind of want to switch just so I can play the new Pocket Camp, not the Pocket Camp, the new Animal Crossing that comes out. It's just really fun. I like it. It's like a good thing to like play when you're trying to unwind. There's something about it. It's just nice. I like it. makes me happy. I don't know if that's an unpopular opinion. I really don't know. But the color scheme was really fun as well. The only problem with the recording was that it was just too bright that day, and kind of messed it up just a little bit. Hopefully you guys can see it. And then the last prompt was ripe. I don't know what it is. I'm just gonna be honest. Why, like, last year it was, what was it? The Evil Queen. And now I have this. And it's like, why do I keep implementing apples? I don't get it. Also, this is another example of me also adding a whole bunch of lines into the hair, and I don't know if that's necessary, but once again, I like it, so whatevs. I wish I added more detail in the background, because all it is like this tree and an apple and nothing but green in the back. So I wish I added just a slight, you know, just a little bit more detail, but I'm really happy on how it turned out. I did enjoy Inktober, but I'm ready to just focus on my other projects and some of the writing stuff and, you know, continue with the original art schedule. But congrats to everyone who finished Inktober. Congrats to anyone who even attempted Inktober. Let me know, did you have a favorite prompt that you did? Did you have a favorite art style that I had done? Is there a certain prompt that was like your favorite? Let me know. I love to hear from you guys. I love hearing your art ideas, and I like to see what you guys create. It's just really fun, and I really like that sense of community. So yeah. Once again, thank you guys so much for watching this video. I know it's probably later than my usual posts, so sorry about that. But hopefully I will have a video coming out probably next week, fingers crossed. But, you know, who knows? We'll see. But thanks again. You guys have an awesome day. Stay creative. God bless. And of course, goodbye.